Good morning, guys. Let's continue our discussion. For the review, yesterday we discussed about what is impressionism. Okay, so we define impressionism as an art movement that emerged in the second half of 19th century among Paris-based artists. Okay, I also gave you this example by Claude Monet, which is the Soleil, L'Avant, okay, English term, alright, Sunrise. What does impressionism artwork represent? Based on our discussion, it represents viewers' momentary impression of an image. What is the influence of Eugène Delacroix in impressionism movement? So Eugène Delacroix uses an expressive brushstroke, emphasis on the movement rather than on the clarity of form, optical effect of the color. So his work has a great influence on the following impressionism artists. Okay, for his works, we have the work of Dante, applying his technique in using impressionism artwork. We also discussed that he uses monochromatic scheme in presenting his painting and artwork. So monochromatic, again, the term used to describe a single color. Yeah, it varies with one another, but only in the form of shading. Let's continue. I'm going to introduce to you the three French painter that we have during the Impressionism movement. We have Manet, and Renoir. Yeah, you heard it right. It pronounces Manet, Monet, and Renoir. So we have here, during 1870s, the stage was set for emerge of next major art movement in Europe. That's why Impressionism is being strengthened or popular in this period. So we have a group of painters that I'm going to give you, including Manet, or first name that we have is Edouard, pronounced as Edouard Manet. Next, Claude Monet. And the third one we have is Auguste Renoir. Yeah. This is a French base name or French name, that's why it pronounces like this. And eventually spread to other countries such as Italy, Germany, and Netherlands. I'm going to introduce to you my grandfather. We have Claude Monet, born in 1840, died 1946. Claude Monet is very prominent as he is one of the founders of Impressionism movement, the most prominent and influential. Why prominent and influential? Because he is very known for his landscape painting, particularly those depicting beloved flower garden, water lily ponds in Giverny. Okay, and I guess this is a common subject in all our painters, even the Filipino painters, that they usually do their artwork or paint some landscape, nature, background. So we're very familiar with this subject. That's why he is one of the prominent influencer of that particular subject. Next we have his artwork. We have the La Promenade, 1875. If you can see, there is a lady wearing a white dress, a white crown, with a boy wearing also a white suit, still showing the landscape of an open field. Next we have the red boat, 1875. Well, the scenery will just talk about how nature works. Meaning, this is a particular place where we used to go to. Bridge over a pile of water lilies, 1899. In here, it discussed the monochromatic scheme in doing his artwork, which is a single color dominant of color green. Just the lighter and the darker one. Irises in Monet's garden, 1900. Okay, so a very soothing and a very refreshing painting from him, showing his beautiful flowers. Next we have Edouard Manet. Yeah, you heard it right. It pronounces Edouard Manet, 1832 to 1883. He is one of the first 19th century artists to depict modern line subjects. Modern line. So meaning, a subject that he usually do will talk about common in everyday lives. Especially, we are millennials, right? He was a key figure in the transition from realism to impressionism. Example of his artwork is the Algin 2. Okay, Algin 2, 1874. It's just a typical scenery wherein a boy and a lady having their sweet conversation, a friendly conversation, with a beautiful scenery behind them. Next is, how you got to pronounce this word, the Romans share decor with flags. Actually, if the title is not given already, so you cannot identify easily what is the subject all about. But when you see with flags, you can identify that there are flags there, that is an aisle or a road. Next, the bar at the Folly Verger, 1883. It's just a typical scene, a lady with some wines at the bar, common subject. Cafe concert, 1878, coffee shop, scene from a coffee shop. Next, I would like to introduce to you Auguste Renoir. Auguste Renoir, along with Claude Monet, was one of the center figures of the Impressionist movement. What is his technique? Oh, how we're going to characterize his works? Along with Claude Monet, he was one. No? His early works were snapshots or real life, full of sparkling color and light. Okay, so meaning, he usually do some paintings wherein there are sparkling or exaggeration of light usage. Broke away from impressionism and applied more disciplined formal technique to portrait of actual people and figure paintings. I have here some of his work. We have Dancer, 1874. Okay, try to analyze and look at the picture here. Okay, the dancer, unlike the other impressionism painting that I have shown you in our previous lesson, those are not yet defined or precise or exact in body sketching or the body parts or body figures. In here, the precision is one of the characteristics or techniques of Renoir, and also the outstanding characteristic here is the usage of sparkling color or sparkling light color. Just try to look at the body of the dancer. So it has a very white complexion. Next, a girl with a watering can, 1876, although some of the parts here are not clearly shown, background is being blurred here, but the person or the girl itself has its precision as a technique of Renoir. Next. Mademoiselle Irene had the adverse. Okay, 1880. One of the trademarks and characteristics of Renoir works talks about portraits. Next, luncheon of the boarding party, 1881. Okay, here, light is being used throughout the painting. After meeting the French artist, are you now ready to have your own artwork? Well, I hope so. So I will give you an activity for you to practice your painting skills. Okay? Are you excited?